Welcome to the AARP version of the show.
I want to thank Rick and David for allowing me to perform here at the Strand. David said to me, he said, you know, Dan, I got to give you a little advice before you perform. You talk too quickly between jokes. You don't give people time to laugh. So what I want you to do is take a glass of water up here. Every time you tell a joke and hear a laugh, I want you to take a drink. But don't take a drink until you hear a laugh. I said, David, if I have to wait to hear a laugh, I'm going to end up dying of thirst. Hey, did you hear on the news about, this is a true story, about this mother who drove through Checkers restaurant to get hamburgers and fries for her children? When she got the bag of hamburgers and fries, she looked in the, opened it up, looked at the bottom of it, and the bottom of it were 5-6 small, tiny little bags of marijuana. I don't know about you, but that is one awesome happy meal. And then did you hear this past year they came out and said, Hillary Clinton gets $200,000 per speaking engagement. $200,000. Can you imagine what she charges Bill for sex? And then I remember when Mitt Romney ran for president some years back, it came out in the news that he was Mormon. And I never knew much about Mormons, so I researched them. Do you know Mormon men can have several wives? Some can have up to 5. I'm Jewish. I couldn't imagine having 5 Jewish wives. If I had 5 Jewish wives, if you had 5 Jewish wives, they say, not tonight, I got a headache. If I had 5 Jewish wives and he had 5 Jewish wives, the only thing they make for dinner is reservations. And what's that old joke? Why did the Jewish guy die before his 5 Jewish wives? Because he wanted to. So I went to Japan about 6 months ago to call on a Japanese client. I get to his office. He says to me, Dan, I'd like you to meet my geisha girl. I said, you what? She goes, I'd like you to meet my geisha girl. I said, your geisha girl? I don't need to meet your geisha girl, I'm married. He goes, no, I insist, you must meet my geisha girl. So the geisha girl comes to the office, I introduce myself, she checks me up and down, and she looks at me and said, sir, I'm concerned about your erection. I said, what? She goes, I'm concerned about your erection. I said, my erection? She said, yes, I'm concerned about your U.S. erection. Who is going to win the next U.S. erection? Hillary or Donald Trump? So also in the news this past year, they were talking about putting a famous woman's face on the $20 bill. And it came down between Eleanor Roosevelt and Harriet Tubman. And Harriet Tubman went out, she'll be on the next $20 bill. But all I could think is, while they're debating which famous woman's face to put on a $20 bill, all I could think is, if they put a woman's face on a $20 bill, that $20 bill's gonna be nagging me to spend it. Anyway, so is it a bad sign that my wife posted my picture on Match.com? I had a cousin of mine, about 57 years old. She got divorced, and pretty attractive, and she joined Match.com. And the first picture she gets of a guy totally naked with a ding-dong sticking straight out. She called me up. She went, Dan, I can't believe this guy sent me a picture of himself totally naked with a ding-dong sticking straight out. I said, well, at least he got right to the point. Not only that, you date a guy like that, you're dating the guy who can hold 2 cups of coffee and 4 donuts at the same time. And what is it with these Ubers? Have you noticed these Uber shops opening up all over the, not Uber, I mean hookah shop. What is it with these hookah shops opening up all over Atlanta? You see these hookah shops? I had never heard of a hookah before, but I understand it's like a Turkish pipe that kids sit around smoking. So I went to a restaurant the other day, and like I said, I'd never heard of a hookah before. So a waitress came up to me and said, would you like a hookah? I said, no, I picked my hookahs up in downtown Atlanta on Peachtree Street. And you know, before I started this comedy thing, I used to be a very successful real estate agent. I used to sell about 4 houses a week, 4 a week. Of course, the people living in the home didn't know I put them up for sale, but hey, I got them a really good price. So anyway, so any married couples here? Are you 2 married over there? Ma'am, how many years have you been happily married? And sir, how many years do you think you've been happily married?
18.
No, better. I've been happily married 30 years. My wife's been happily married 15. And the sex is great as long as it's consensual. She said, I love it when you make love to me while I'm sleeping. I said, that's nice, why do you say that? She goes, at least I can dream I'm having good sex. The other day I jumped into bed, I pulled the blankets over my head. She looked at me and said, when you pull a blanket over your head, you remind me of a pick and a blanket. And I said, so eat me. She said, when I look at you, I think of that Nicolas Cage movie, Gone in 60 Seconds. I said, why is that? She goes, because we have sex, you're done in 60 seconds. But she said to me the other day, she said, Dan, in every marriage, each spouse should be able to have one affair. Every spouse should at least be able to have one affair. Then she looks at me and said, your turn. The other day, my wife... Delayed reaction. The other day, my wife almost ran off with an Uber driver, and she changed her mind because when she called him, he came too quickly. I can say that one again if you want. It's a thank you joke. The other day, my wife and I, we went out to eat at a Chinese restaurant, and after dinner, they brought me a little fortune cookie. So I opened it up and said, the fortune said, for good fortune, do everything your wife tells you to do today. But I really didn't feel like jumping off a cliff. And what is it? And my wife, you know, I love the news. I get all my news from a website called nakednews.com. Have you ever heard of it? It's where these beautiful blonde-haired, blue-eyed girls read the news to you on the naked. It's $24.95 a month. My wife said, for $24.95 a month, I'll read the news to you naked. I said, I'll pay you $50 not to. I post a lot of marriage jokes online. So my wife comes to me the other day and says, Dan, I love your marriage jokes. Keep posting as many marriage jokes as you possibly can. In fact, post a lot of jokes about me too. I said, finally, you realize these are jokes of love. She goes, no, my divorce attorney said they're admissible in court. So let me think here. You know what I love to do? The biggest problem with my wife's and I's marriage is snoring. The biggest problem I have in our marriage is snoring. When I snore, it just wakes my wife up. When she snores, it wakes both of us up. The other night, she was snoring incessantly, just loudly and incessantly, and I inadvertently grabbed her boobie, and she stopped snoring. And I said to myself, I gotta patent this. So the next day, I'm sitting in Starbucks next to a lady in one of the more comfortable chairs, and she actually falls, and she was reading her iPad, and she fell asleep, and she started snoring. So I took that opportunity to look at her boobie, and I said to myself, do I squeeze it or do I not? So I squeezed it. It didn't go well, but it's not what she thinks. She's stalking me now. She's 85 years old. She wants me to squeeze the other boobie. So you know what I love to do? I love to wear a bright red shirt and walk around Target and misdirect customers. But another thing I like to do, I love to teach young adults valuable, valuable lessons. I was sitting in Starbucks the other day, and a young guy walks in with his briefcase. He sits down next to me and takes out his iPhone, his iPad, and his laptop, and he sets them on the table. He said, sir, would you watch my stuff while I go to the restroom? I said, I'd be happy to. Once he was in the restroom, I quickly picked up my new iPhone, my new iPad, and my new laptop, and I put it in my briefcase. And I left him a note. The note said, son, when you get back, if your stuff is missing, then I'm missing. Apparently, you asked the wrong person to watch your stuff. And this should teach you a very, very valuable lesson. So, ma'am, can I hold something that's really valuable? Just for a moment. I won't hurt it. See, you're welcome. See, isn't it amazing when people hand you and you have a microphone in your hand? It's like you got it. Now, young lady, hand me your boob. Either one, I'm not your boob. You're wrong. Either one of you. I'm sorry. The boob would be fine, too. Anyway. See, if I was a robber, I would use a gun. I'd use a Mr. Microphone. I'd come upon someone and say, halt, hand me your wallet and nobody gets hurt. Now show me your breasts. Thank you, sir. And you know, it's getting hard to get a job. In order to get a job, you have to have experience. But how do you get experience if you don't have a job? So I started robbing banks for a living. But with my luck, the first bank I went into, I slid a note to the teller that said, this is a stick-up. The teller read the note and looked at me and said, sir, do you have a resume? Have you ever robbed a bank before? Do you have any experience? We just don't hand our money to anyone. Now you run along, get some experience, rob a couple more banks, maybe a teller machine or two. Then when you come back, we'll see what we can do for you. And sir, next time you rob a bank, please don't use a Mr. Microphone. And no, I won't show you my breasts. Well, maybe once. No, I'm just kidding. Anyway, I'm too old to be up here. I'm 59, physically it's getting tough. It was like even hard getting out of the car. It felt like it took me 2-3 minutes. It was a real struggle. Of course, it would have helped if I remembered to unbuckle the seatbelt, but hey, that's the good thing about dementia. You meet new people every day. And it's not getting older that bothers me. It's not the fact that I'm getting gray hair. I can't hold my liquor or my pee-pee, and I have to wear Depends. What bothers me is the time I've wasted. There's an old saying, it's too bad youth has to be wasted on the young. In other words, if I knew then what I know now, I'd want to start over. And I do want to start over, but I don't want to start over as a baby. I want to start over from the very beginning. I want to start over as a spermatozoa. See, I remember life before I was born. I remember going to a party with my father and leaving with my mother. And when I was a young spermatozoa, I wasn't very popular. All the other spermatozoas used to swim around me saying, Danny's missing the chromosome, Danny's missing the chromosome. And I didn't have many friends, and when a little spermatozoid friend was supposed to meet me, he would never show up on time. And then when they did finally show up, I would say, hey, Jack, you late? And I wasn't very good with the little spermatozoid girls, but there was one I liked. Her name was Mary. I swam over to her one night, and I said, hey, Mary, here the weather's nice outside. Do you want to come? Anyway, so I have this online comedy show called Comics on Parole. If you go to comicsonparole.com, you'll see the, it's just a talk show with all the local comics here in Atlanta. But we've had some famous people on. We've had some people with Nick and Brian, Conan and Brian, Married with Children. But the reason we call it Comics on Parole is because I went into comedy because it was part of my parole agreement. My parole officer said you have a choice of one or two parole agreements. You could do stand-up comedy or sweep sidewalks. And we strongly suggest you sweep sidewalks. But I chose stand-up comedy. And as you can see, it's not going well. I bombed so much, the FBI put me on a terrorist watch list. I bombed so much, the U.S. Air Force left a message on my answer machine. Hey, we'd like to recruit you. We hear you're good at bombing. But since starting this Comics on Parole thing, I've become very popular. I got called to perform at a parachutist convention the other day. The guy said, the only thing is you'll have to tell your jokes while you're parachuting, but don't worry, there's no strings attached. But listen, you know what, Dave? Thank you, Rick. Thank you for inviting me here to perform here. You know, I find the customers here at Strand Theater are the highest character, the most honest, and the highest quality I've ever seen. In fact, I'll show you their honesty. Last time I was here and performed, I lost my debit card in this theater. 2-3 days later, a gentleman called me up and said, is your name Daniel Glazer? I said, yes. He goes, well, I found your debit card. I said, great, where do I meet you to get it? He said, Hawaii. Yeah. Not only that, I really was calling to see if you could add a few more dollars to the balance. Anyway, you've been a great crowd. Thank you very much. Thank you.